Now that I explained our methodology and our way of working on predictions, we would like to give an example for a specific industry, and we choose the chocolate industry to be the first one. We considered two critical questions that we wanted to have the answers to, and those questions are: which ingredients will be affected by hazards during the next months? What type of emerging issues should I prepare for in the near future? The results we got told us that the sugar and syrups are ingredient category with a decrease in hazards, from 17 incidents that happened during the last 12 months to only 10 during the next 12 months. On the other hand, the hazards associated with hazelnuts are going to increase by 73%, from 22 to 38. We will further analyze the peanuts due to the biggest number of expected incidents, from 87 to 125. We can see the incident trends for peanuts for the next 12 months in this diagram. The prediction is that there will be an increase in incidents, but 44% based on the pattern of incidents of the last 20 years. Talking about the hazards that are expected to increase in peanuts, mycotoxins are expected to increase by 35%, from 74 to 100. Specifically, aflatoxin by 31%, from 74 to 97. Plus, two fraud issues are expected to increase, like absence of health certificate and absence of certified analytical report. According to our prediction algorithms, we are expecting an increase of 31% of the aflatoxin risk in peanuts, and the trend is looking like this. Let's see how the interconnected data can give us insights and predictions in a very important sector of the supply chain, like the dairy industry. For instance, Listeria monocytogenes, Escherichia coli, and Salmonella will increase in the next few months. In the same way, we can analyze all of our ingredients and their expected hazards, and also predict the recalls that may happen because of those. Having all that information at hand, it's much easier for the food safety and quality professional to activate preventive measures like: identify the risky points of their supply chain, activate early the corrective measures for the risky points of the supply chain and avoid recalls and/or border rejections, design the most efficient lab analysis plan that will focus on the emerging hazards, and design the most efficient audits plan. So, start moving from reaction to prevention. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our weekly food safety intelligence newsletter to stay up to date with the latest industry news.